Wahigurjika Khalsa.
Wahigurjika Fateh.
Thank you very much. And it's great to see you here today at the WSP offices. Can you tell us about this event?
Well, first of all, yeah, this is just a most beautiful office, isn't it, here in the centre of Birmingham. Just sets a standard of what offices should be. But what we're doing today is we're launching the West Midlands Design Charter. And it's basically talking about the type of buildings, spaces that we'd like to see and the standards they should be constructed to into the future. It's a voluntary collaboration between us and local authorities, but hopefully it will help the industry to really lift the design standards across the region.
And you know, climate change has become a huge issue and buildings are a big part of that in taking up resource, heat and energy. Where do you stand on this climate debate and where can we fit design into that?
Yeah, very interesting question. Design's a critical part of this. So where I and indeed the combined authority are is we declared our climate emergency last summer because we said this is so, so, so important. And just last week, actually, we then agreed how we were going to get to carbon neutrality by 2041. So it's a tough, ambitious programme and critically good design in terms of thermal insulation and all those things, the energy efficiency of buildings, that's a critical part of meeting that challenge.
We've got a housing crisis here in the West Midlands, and you've made great efforts to try and address that. What are your plans for the future for the housing crisis? Bearing in mind, many people just want a house to live in, and they're not concerned with fancy designs.
You're quite right that we've got to build more homes. Just to give you the historical numbers, we've actually begun to do much, much better. So last year alone, we built 17,000 homes across the West Midlands. That was a third up on 2 years ago and was double what we were doing just 6 years ago. So actually, we've really responded quickly in terms of plans going forward. We're really looking to regenerate all those derelict brownfield sites. We've just announced with Sandwell a huge site at Friar Park, sites in Walsall, sites in Wolverhampton, more coming in Sandwell. I was at one in Oldbury last week. So we really have got momentum around this regenerative agenda.
Will that continue into the future?
It definitely will continue in the future. So long as I'm mayor, I'm determined to pursue that brownfield regeneration policy.
Tremendous. Housing also needs jobs. We'd like to see more design jobs here in the West Midlands. WSP is a great example of a huge company centred around design based here in Birmingham. How can you attract more companies like WSP?
Well, the reason why WSP came here is really straightforward. They saw that there was lots of work to be done. So the rather simple answer, but it's oh so true, is make sure that the construction sector is really, really strong, because then the engineers, the quantity surveyors, the designers, everybody has a reason to be here. And we've actually seen lots of new companies moving into Birmingham in that sector. So everything we do to win investment, make sure things are being built, actually generates the job opportunities for those designers.
Brexit is over and done in terms of the election at least and making a firm decision, but this is going to rumble on for a while yet, and you've got a election coming up soon. How will Brexit tie into your election?
Well, you're absolutely right. The Prime Minister said get Brexit done, and actually just yesterday in Parliament the actual legislation went through for us to leave. So in that sense he delivered his promise, and I think where that relates to my election, people will say Conservative Prime Minister, Conservative Mayor, they deliver on their promises. But you're also right to say the next stage of the Brexit negotiation in terms of making sure the trade deal we do with Europe, that's still a really live issue. And what I'll be doing is making sure we get the best deal for West Midlands businesses, particularly those in the manufacturing sector who export product to and from Europe.
And the Sikh community have a strong attachment to the Commonwealth, whether it's India or Australia or Canada and the wider Indian community. How can you lever that better with the Commonwealth Games coming up?
Yeah, well, of course, the Commonwealth Games are coming. We're looking forward to about a billion people watching Birmingham all around the world. And one thing we want to do is show that this is genuinely a community for all ethnicities, all faiths. So there's a great sort of representative bit there. But there's another thing as well, actually, with India. If you think of what we're doing to try to get direct flights to India, we've got the flight to Amritsar. That was very important. We're now pressing for Mumbai, and we're not long away to launch actually the West Midlands India Partnership to think about the business relationships with India. So there's that as well.
That's tremendous. Thank you very much, Andy Street. It's great to catch up with you, and we look forward to seeing more of you in the next few months.
I'm very much looking forward to coming on Seek Channel again. You know I love being on Seek Channel, so any invitation, we'll be there.
Well, look forward to seeing you on the breakfast show. And this time, I think we'll have some more for you, rather than Brant.
That will be much to look forward to. Thank you very much indeed.